Hello everybody, welcome back to a Let's Play. This is Nova Persona. This time I'm going to be playing The Last Door. I don't know too much about this game other than it's a 2D point and click Lovecraft inspired game. So, that being said, I think I'm ready to start. This is going to be a blind playthrough, and I'm gonna try to set the mood as much as possible. I'm not gonna talk too much, at least not quite too often, because I want the mood to be set. Again, if you're watching this, turn the lights off, put your headphones on. I'm not expecting it to be too terribly scary, seeing as the game is very pixelated. But I've heard that the pixels really set the tone, and that the sense of dread and mystery comes out because it is pixelated. Because you don't get a very clear picture of what's going on. And my cat is here. She's gonna be playing along with us, so let's go ahead and start episode one. After all the things I have seen. Oh, I get to click. Let's see, before we start. Let me turn the music down to one. After all the things I have seen. I picked up a rope. I cannot escape the course my life has taken. Oh no. Now I am beyond redemption. I just hope you can forgive me someday. Yours sincerely, Anthony Beecher. Well, that wasn't the cheeriest introduction to a game. I'll let it play through the credits. So that's the other thing I know about this game, is that it is crowdfunded. I do believe there's more episodes coming out. Currently there's only four. October 1891. That was all my childhood friend, Anthony Beechworth, had written in his letter. It had been many years since I had heard that sentence. It was the motto of the science and philosophy group that we had secretly run as students back when we were in that secluded boarding school in Scotland. But we had left all behind, like mere childhood memories. That letter was unusual. It could only mean something awful must have happened. Something that must remain absolutely secret. I had to find out what was going on. Without delay, I took the first morning train to Sussex and made my way up to the address on the letter. And there it was. The old house of Anthony's family, the Beechworth Manor. So on the letter. So I guess this is my inventory, so that I can look at things. Look at anything here. The fields surrounding the house stretched majestically as far as the eye could see. I did not know Anthony was the owner of such a property. There are so many birds that I cannot see their prey from here. A garbage bin. Judging by how older I would say it has not been emptied in a fortnight. Let's go in through the front. This is strange. Everything is silent, as if there was no one living here. I'm worried about Anthony. I have to find him. My coat. Is this Anthony? The years have not been kind to him. Note on the table. Dear Mr. Beechworth, due to the recent events, the situation has become unbearable for us, and much to our regret, we have no other choice but to leave. We will remain forever grateful for all these years in your service. God bless you, Mr. and Mrs. Brewer. So this must be the servants. I don't know what the recent events could have been. Look for Anthony. The grandfather clock. It is the only sound around here. Anthony! Where are you, Anthony? A machine that plays recorded music. I did not know that Anthony was such an enthusiast of new inventions. A cabinet with glasses and some liquor bottles. There is also a match. These matches could come in useful. large window is wide open, letting the cold dusk air in. A fireplace. It looks like it has not been cleaned in a long time. A deer head overlooks the room. Dark in here. A seascape. There is a small boat struggling against the roaring waves. This is a rainy mountain landscape. This portrait is crooked. Let's see if we can't fix it. Well, something happened. I heard a mechanism click. This painting depicts a deep, dark forest. A small plant brings some life to this place. This must have been the servant's quarters. A wash basin and some toiletries. A lamp to light the way. This will be handy. There is nothing of interest in these drawers. The window is so dirty that I can barely see through to the outside. An empty bowl, like the ones used to feed pets. A note. March 5th, 1891. Master Anthony has made us get rid of our religious objects. What is going on with him? Luckily, I have found the place to hide my rosary. I cannot pray every night without it. May 18th, 1891. Master Anthony has been complaining about Alfie. What would a simple cat do to him? He ordered us to keep him out of the house at all times. Still, I cannot let that poor thing starve. He is such a clever cat. Every time I open the window, he knows food is waiting for me. Anyway, I'm worried about Master Anthony. He is growing more and more unlike himself every day. September 15th, 1891. Master Anthony is spending whole days locked inside his office. He wants us to leave him food at the door, but he barely eats anything. I'm really worried. So it seems that Anthony suffered a change over time. There is a discoloration on the wall in the shape of a cross, as if one had hung there for many years and had been recently removed. There is a tiny dark hole in the wall. Can I use my lamp to see into the dark? I cannot. Should I light the lamp first? Yes, I can. Now can I see into the dark hole? I still cannot. Let's go back to the other hallway. The door is locked. I should try and find the key to open it. Well, let's see if us moving the portrait has opened up any secret passages anywhere. The kitchen. The kitchen stove and a cleaning cloth. might come in handy. I'll take it. Plates and pans. A plate with some days-old leftovers. A variety of herbs and ingredients. I guess I don't need any of that. I've unlatched the door. This must be the door that leads to the backyard where the crows were. Horrible. Try the first door. It's locked. Stuck, rather. It's very ominous in this hallway. This door seems to be boarded up. I wonder why. Some square areas on the wall are visibly cleaner. It looks like some of the paintings are missing. I wonder if they were religious paintings and were taken down whenever Anthony had his transformation. Some square areas on the wall are visibly cleaner. Anything on this corner? Try this room. Was this Anthony's room? A silver key. This might unlock the other room. The fireplace is black with soot. A gentleman with a serious, inquisitive look. Small photographs and old daguerreotypes, mostly family portraits. In case you're not familiar, daguerreotypes were a very early photography printing method. It's no use taking any of them. This window leads to a balcony shared with the adjacent room. Open the latch. It is stuck. Perhaps I could do so with a small tool. I doubt this will work. A double bed. From the accumulated dust, I would guess it has not been slept in for a very long time. I wonder what I can use the cloth for. Locked from the inside. Perhaps this silver key will open the door in the hallway downstairs. Thank you. see, if I remember correctly, there was a dirty window in this room. I wonder if I need to wipe it. Nope. I hope this unlocks the door. The door is locked. Let's use the key on it. The basement, it seems. I think this is a slate disc record. The sleeve reads, "The Carnival of Venice." I'll take it. We'll play it upstairs. A slightly rusted iron crowbar. Perhaps I can use this to open the window. A small pile of firewood, twigs, and chunks of dry bark. I would think these things would be so humid downstairs. The boiler looks like it has been out of use for a long time. Anything inside to justify prying it open. This looks like a bricked up passageway right here. Let's go play the record. Let's see if that'll give us any indication as to what we should do next. To be interested in me, but the window is now closed and the drapes are drawn. I don't think there's anything I can do here at the moment. Let's go upstairs and open that window. Actually, I think I might need to pull off the boards with the crowbar. Looks like it's written in blood. I am writing what will surely be my final thoughts, my last lines, my last breath. I do not know what kind of dark power has turned my husband into what he is now, a stranger, with a look bereft of all sanity, compassion, and human warmth. I do not know what shadow has slowly darkened our lives. I do not know this foreign guest that now dwells in our souls. I do not know where it is from, but I am sure it is not from this world. I will meet my brothers and sisters soon. I will be free from this abyss of madness and fear. Soon, I will stop trembling. She dropped a simple, long hairpin. I'm sure we can use this in the room adjacent. An old wheelchair. Jeez, even in a game like this, there's a wheelchair. Another letter. Dear Margaret, it has been days since Anthony left his office. I can hear him whisper, angrily, frightfully, and it gets worse at night. Our service left a few days ago. Without their help and company, I am lost. I can barely walk out of bed, and not even the doctor will come here after his argument with Anthony. My husband has developed a horrible ability to break anyone's will. I do not know what to do. I do not have the strength left. I wish I could send you this letter. Your dear friend, Anna Beechworth. This must be Anthony's wife. Forgot to pick it up. A letter in feeble handwriting. I cannot go on. All is lost. A diary page. I cannot stand their stares. They watch me. They judge me. They despise me. I know they think I am not worthy of this family. But who are they but dust and bones? A memory. Leave me. I do not need you. Leave me alone. Who is they? Should I try to wipe it? This must be the day she was talking about. So there's a tapping at the window. A portrait of Anthony standing beside a mounted wildcat, or lynx. The paint looks fresher around the animal's head. Was Anna the one painting these? A man with blonde hair. I feel as if I've seen him before. This young woman, not yet in her 20s, stares defiantly back at me. There is a big raven perched outside the window, tapping on the glass with its beak. This old man bears some resemblance to Anthony, but his countenance is marred by a severe, unsettling gaze. I wonder if it is Anthony, or his father. She looks like the woman on the bed. She is holding a baby. Could that be Anthony's child? If so, what has happened to the child? A woman of strong features and dark hair. She has a bold look in her eyes. The young Anthony, just like I remember him. I guess we'll have to make our way out to the balcony from the other room. And see why that raven keeps rapping on the window. Using the hairpin, I have managed to spring the latch with ease. Mounted and stuffed. This is a fine work of taxidermy. Some torn out diary pages. They will not bother me anymore. I am done with their censorious gazes, their whispers. It is all ready. There is only one thing left to do. A common hammer in good condition. This might come in handy. A map of the region of Sussex with markings drawn on its surface. A few press cuttings pinned to the wall. The illustrated London News, 1887. Judge kills himself under strange circumstances. The Daily Telegraph, 1888. Earl found dead floating in the Thames. The Times, 1889. Famous actor found bled to death in his hotel room. There must be a connection. The remains of chemical experiments. A can of paint thinner. Might come in handy. I'm guessing we're gonna have to remove some of the paint on those portraits and see if there is anything underneath. Some sort of spilled chemical product. It smells strongly of vinegar. On top of the ladder, there is a trapdoor with a keyhole, reinforced with gold. I'm guessing I can't go up there. The Golden Horse trapdoor is locked. I need to find the key. Okay, so one of the portraits has been fresh paint around the cat's face. So let's see if we can't pour the thinner directly onto the canvas. It would move every layer of paint, the French image, as well as whatever it originally lay behind it. Okay, so let's just use a little bit. The thinner has worked, the fresh paint is gone, and now I see the original painting. The lynx's mouth is open, as if it were growling. There must be something inside the lynx's mouth. I do not know what this animal will be used for yet. I can't think of anything. Perhaps I need to scare the crows away with the hammer. Well, I am not sure. Thank you. thing of interest. What should I do with this? Whoa. Maybe there's some sort of magic on the taxidermy zinc. But I doubt it. Maybe I need to take this to the room where that other crow was tapping on the window. See if that has any effect. So I did flip the portrait in the hallway down on this side. Oh, you know what? I bet I'm gonna have to put the crow in the hole in the service space. Now that I think about it, and put it by the window, and then the cat is gonna come and eat it. Also, this mysterious hole right there. Yep. Okay, so now it's there. Maybe I can make the hole bigger? No? Let's leave and come back in. It's still there. There. Oh, do I need to break the window open? I wonder. Because it's closed at the moment. Oh, I need to open it. There we go. Okay, so it's open. It looks like the window frame is rotten. I would need some kind of cord to hold the window open. Cord. Didn't say he had his rosaries. Maybe I can use that as well. There's a way to make the window open. What else is a cord? I don't think there was anything in the basement with a cord. Maybe I should flip this back. Oh, an old rosary, a cord of beads with a solid wooden music base. I can use this to hold the window open. That should do it. Now the cat should come. We need the bird. Maybe. I hear something in the distance. It sounds like a lament. Gone, and there's just a trail of blood that leads through the hole in the wall. You know what? I'm willing to bet that the cat upstairs has its mouth open with the dead crow in it. Couldn't be in there. That room, that wall would be over here somewhere. Sound is louder down here. The cat must be somewhere in here. It's not in the stove, is it? Cat seems to be behind this one. A black cat is staring at me. But wait, its eyes are missing. No. I ran off. Good lord. It almost ripped my eyes out. It has run away into the dark. There is an open chest with a dark cloak, a mask, and a knife. The knife could be useful. There's nothing else of use. Okay, the knife might be useful. I'm trying. Open. The cat upstairs. managed to get the lynx's mouth open. There is a golden key inside. Let's use it. Oh god, no. Anthony, no! A portrait of a woman. Anthony's wife, perhaps? She looks very happy here. The lifeless body of my dear friend. What madness could have led him to commit such an act? There is something in his pocket. It is a sealed letter. Dear J. Devitt, if you are reading these lines and I am nothing but a dead body hanging before you, I write to you in my last shreds of lucidity. You are one of my oldest friends. When I sent you the letter asking you to come here, I did not doubt for one moment that you would. Had you failed me this evening, everything would have been lost. I have found myself involved in a series of horrible incidents. For reasons beyond my comprehension and sanity, I have become a total stranger to myself and to my closest relatives, capable of the most indescribable and atrocious acts. I cannot give you any more details at this time. I must ask you to go immediately back to the boarding school where we made that pact, where we all swore on our honor that sentence that would protect us. This letter must not reach anyone else, so it is imperative that you destroy it immediately. The lives of the rest of the group, and yours too, are in great danger. Do not delay. They are already waiting for you. Seeing is believing, Devitt. Do not forget that. Always your loyal friend, Anthony Beechworth. Jeez, I'm gonna jump. Oh no, they're devouring here. Oh no. The adventure continues in episode 2. The letter was funded by Kickstarter by 285 backers. It was, couldn't read it that fast. Alright guys, well, that's episode 1 of The Last Door. I'm gonna try to do all 4 episodes before the end of October. So I'm gonna post this today. But thank you all for watching. If you'd liked this Let's Play, go ahead and leave a thumbs up and subscribe, and I'll have lots more where these come from. So, I'm just going to see if there's anything else, but it looks like it's saying the same things over and over. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching. I'll be back with episode 2.